Hello everyone, I am Mr. Sunil Kumar from the Department of Mechanical Engineering. As you know, I am teaching you the course Finite Element Analysis and we have completed Module 1. Presently we were dealing with the contents of Module 2. In this regard, I will be sharing number of videos with respect to Module 2, and this is the first video and we shall consider it as Video 2.1. Module 2 contains number of derivations on shape functions or interpolation functions on different types of finite elements and also analysis of bars and trusses. Before going to what is shape function, let us understand about the basics of coordinate systems. As we know, coordinate system is a space where any geometrical figure is represented. So until now we have learnt two types of coordinate system. One is Cartesian coordinate system, the other one is polar coordinate system. In Cartesian coordinate system we use x, y, z as coordinates. In polar coordinate system we use r, theta, etc. as coordinates. But in finite element formulation, there are three types of coordinate system that we use. One is global coordinate system, local coordinate system, and natural coordinate system. So again, I will repeat, in FEA formulation, we use three types of coordinate systems. One is global, local, and natural. So we shall learn what is global coordinate system. Here, if we observe in this figure, a geometry is given. This geometry we can consider it as 2D truss. This is a 2D truss geometry having number of elements. We can see element 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So here entire truss member, the entire geometry is represented in coordinates x and y. Since it is 2D, there is no z axis. So entire geometry is represented in x and y. If that is the case, then it is known as global coordinate system. So here any point in the geometry is identified with respect to these coordinates x and y. So further, we can say that if entire geometry is represented in the coordinates, then that type of coordinate system is called as global coordinate system. Coming to the local coordinate system, here a particular element is assigned with coordinates. As I told, there are number of elements in this earlier figure. Now if I consider a separate element, element 1, element 2, etc., each element can be assigned with coordinates, that is x prime and y prime. So here element 2 also is assigned with coordinates x prime and y prime. So if each element is represented in the coordinates, then this type of coordinate system is called as local coordinate system. So if entire geometry is represented, it is global. If a particular element is represented, it is local. Similarly, when coming to the natural coordinate system, here in this figure we can see a 1D element having node 1 and node 2. So in a particular node in this element is assigned with coordinate. Here zeta is the coordinate assigned for that particular node. For the node 1, the value of zeta is minus 1. At node 2, the value of zeta is plus 1. So it means the natural coordinate is a dimensionless set of numbers whose magnitude lies from minus 1 to plus 1 only. That is, the value of the coordinate over the element from node 1 to node 2 lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So we can assign the coordinate value anywhere over the element and its value will be in between minus 1 to plus 1. So to summarize, a particular node can be assigned with coordinate. So if a particular node is assigned with coordinate, That type of coordinate system is called as natural coordinate system. So since it is 1D, zeta is the only coordinate assigned. If it is 2D, zeta and eta. If it is 3D, one more term such as pi can be used. So there are three types of coordinate system in FEA. One is global, in which entire geometry is represented. Second one is local, in which element is assigned with coordinates. Third one is natural coordinate system, in which particular node is assigned with the coordinates.